Hello everybody and welcome back again to Let's Play Assassin's Creed 3, where we finally met the first real assassin of the game, Achilles, and he agreed to train Connor. Apparently they already have been training for a few months, but obviously Connor is not a full assassin yet. He doesn't have a hidden blade, doesn't have a rope, so I guess he still has a long way ahead of him. Also, we learned that Connor apparently does know about Haytham, so he knows that he is his father. I guess that Zio told him about that. Of course, I don't really know how much Zio knew about Haytham's activities and affiliations. I mean, obviously she did know that he was looking for these ancient sacred symbols. And I actually wonder if maybe she showed him the wrong place on purpose. Because apparently the tribe, or at least like the elders of the tribe, know the location of a real temple. And I think the codex said that Zio was trained by the elders, so maybe she knew as well. But obviously she wasn't going to show it to some outsider. And since she wanted Haytham's help to kill Braddock, I guess she was just like, yeah, to keep my side of the bargain, I'm just going to show him some minor side that isn't really all that important, and that's going to throw him off for a while at least. And I guess it worked, at least for a few years, until Charles Lee decided that the tribe probably knows more than that, and that's when they attacked the village. But yeah, we have our targets, at least I assume these are going to be our targets in this game on the wall. And I guess I'm going to look around this house a little bit before we check out our next mission. So, well, it looks all very homely. Got a kitchen here. Well, this part does not look quite as homely. I mean, it's all covered up as if nobody has been living here for a while. Well, got a desk that is not covered up. And we also got upstairs rooms. Let's check them out as well. I wonder what's under all these blankets. Yeah, not much to do here. But I'm sure once you put some effort into this, it's going to look all nice again. Oh, well, we do have like some kind of map over here. Interesting. And a few paintings as well. Okay, yeah, I guess I'm just going to leave now. The next main mission is right outside the door, and I think I'm going to continue with the main missions until, you know, I think Connor is actually an assassin and has a hidden blade and stuff like that. And then maybe we can take a bit of a break and deal with some exploration and side content and stuff like that. But for now, we're going to move on with the story. Oh, it's winter again. Alright. So are we going to make a journey? Achilles' errand. Let's see.
Good morning.
To you as well. You taking a trip?
I've decided to do something about the house. Hmm. And you're going to help me. Get it?
Okay. Sounds good to me. So we're back in Boston. I see.
Don't stare.
Sorry.
Come on.
Follow Achilles this without place is incredible. Conflict.
The people, the sounds and smells. I could walk these streets for days and know not even half its wonders.
I thought the same as you upon a time. These days, I much prefer the quiet of the countryside.
But there is so much life here. So many opportunities.
For a few, my boy. Hmm. For a few.
Guess that's right. So, I suppose it's his first trip to the city?
There's a store close to here. You're to buy the items on this list. Tell them where the carriage is, and they'll see that it's loaded. Understood?
Yes.
Good. You're also going to need a new name. Your skin is fair enough that you might pass for one with Spanish or Italian blood. Better to be thought a Spaniard than a native. And both are better still than I.
That is not true.
What's true and what is aren't always the same.
What would you call me then?
Kana. Yes, that will be your name.
That doesn't All really right sound then. Spanish or Italian,
Off you
though.
Go.
Also, I feel that your outfit might give you away, but okay. I guess we're going to the general store now. Yeah, we still have a fully explored map. Interestingly enough, all the viewpoints that Hathem explored are still visible, so I don't have to do that again. And apparently we're going to continue chasing Almanac pages, even though Hathem technically got that quest. So I guess he gave up on finding more pages at some point. Anyway, I guess I'm just going for my next objective right here, or do I want to look around a bit? I mean, there isn't really that much. I can try to pick up a few treasures, so I actually have some money to spend at the shop. Maybe I should do that. So, let's spend a few minutes looking around town again. I mean, I have been through most of this. And let's see how Connor's rooftop running is. Oh well, there's soldiers over here. Gotta stay away from those. Okay, my quest marker is somewhere over there, but my treasure is in this direction, so I should not get too sidetracked here. Why are the streets so wide in the city? It's kind of hard to get from one side of the street to the other. Especially since there aren't any, like, ropes connecting the houses like you would find in Italy. So maybe I'm just going to stay in the streets. Seems to be a little bit faster and safer. Oh, what is this? Don't tread on me. Haven't seen these before in the city. They're like everywhere now. Okay, I guess now I actually have to... Oh! Sorry, lady, I didn't mean to startle you. I also feel that we have more soldiers on rooftops now. More than before. Alright. I can already hear treasure noises. Where is it? Oh, hi! Are you a guard dog? Will you attack me if I open this? Nope. He seems to be fine with me taking the stuff. Okay, I got some money and I got recipes. So, does this mean I can, like, craft items? Yeah, we have another treasure over here, but I think one treasure is enough for now. I have a bit of money, just in case I want to buy more than whatever the quest requires me to buy. I mean, Achilles didn't give me any money, he just said go and buy stuff. So, I'm not sure how he expects us to do this without any money. But we now have some money. I have a recipe for wigs. Okay. Torches. Bear pendant. Huh. This is all very fascinating. Oh, can't climb up here. Need to find a better place for you to climb higher. There we go. There, that's a gap I can jump. Okay, now let's find that general store. Guess it's right around the corner. Is that still the same guy with a courier mission that we saw years ago when we were playing as Hathem? I don't know. Cannot interact while on a mission. Oh, this is not the general store. It just kind of looks like it. This is a general store.
A new rule enforced, all without our consent. The Revenue Act. The Indemnity Act. The Commissioners of Customs Act. Oh, Chancellor Townsend must have thought himself so clever.
These guys look very upset. But I guess they're like the helpful civilians we had in previous games. Okay.
You lost?
I have money.
I need the items on this list.
Will you be paying with coin or trade? Some of these things I have, some I don't. Lumber's hard to come by since my supplier up and vanished. I have the tools and pitch, though. Nails, too. So, where do you want this delivered?
Our wagon is near the state house.
Okay, I got some of the stuff. And since I'm here, maybe I want to do some private shopping.
And here would like.
Let's see, what do you have? Normal weapons, blunt weapons, small weapons, heavy weapons, firearms, consumables, citizen mission items, outfits, maps. Wow. Okay, all of that is still locked. I'm going to assume the only things I can buy are the ones that have an exclamation mark. Stone tomahawk, which is what I already have. I can buy a stone dagger. I don't think it's better than what I have, though. No. Do I have a dagger at all? I mean, I have a tomahawk. Is this like the same thing? I mean, it doesn't seem to increase any of my stats over here, so going to assume I don't really need that. What about maps? Ah, okay. These are treasures. Well, they usually pay off pretty quickly. So I guess I'm going to buy one of these. Like this one. This one I can actually afford. Yes, give me that map. And now I'm almost broke again. So I guess I could try to sell him stuff.
What do you need, my friend?
Let's see. Yeah, I can sell him the stuff that I'm hunting. Huh. Prices aren't very good, though. The fox pelt is apparently the most precious item, and the deer pelt. Okay. Yeah, I don't know. Is there any other use for all of these items? Maybe I'm going to hold on to them for the time being. Well, apparently this door is kind of special because I can't interact with it.
I should return to Achilles.
Who stands in Parliament for Boston?
Alright, let's return.
No one, but old Saruman is
I spent quite some time shopping because now it's night.
We're headed to the customs house to toss some quips at the lobsters.
Oh well,
James,
it seems that
Sam,
people are very agitated everywhere. Look at this.
With me to King Street. We'll show them.
Huh.
What happened?
That's
down
what we're going
to customs
find
house for a spree. Come along.
Follow me.
Okay. So many soldiers everywhere, fighting the civilians. Better not get involved in it. So, where do you want to go?
I say again, disperse! Congregating in this manner is forbidden!
We're not going anywhere, Bug!
Oi! Why don't you go back to England?
No good can come of this chaos! Return to your homes, and all will be forgiven!
Never!
Not until you've answered for your crimes!
You're right, cowards!
You don't scare
us! Pointing guns at unarmed!
We ain't afraid!
Is that my father?
Ooh.
Yes, which means trouble is sure to follow. I need you to Taylor's accomplice. This crowd is a powder keg. We can't allow him to light the fuse. But nothing. Do as I say and go.
Okay.
Come on, you gosh-gutted coward.
Taylor's a suspicious man.
Hey, Lobster! Go ahead! Fire your little gun!
You bit back!
Okay, he's going this way. We have lots of people in the streets. This might actually work in my favor. So I think I'm going to stay on the streets and not, like, try to go on the rooftops or whatever. Where are you going? You are very confusing. Maybe I should give him some space.
Boy, you there! What's all the fuss about?
Fire at the townhouse.
Okay, now he's talking with the civilians over here. Alright, now he's moving on. I think you can, like, take cover behind corners, right? Okay. Let's do that. And now he's walking through here. Oh, he's climbing the walls. Well, it seems like the Templars changed their methods in the past few hundred years. I mean, suddenly they're using hidden blades and they're climbing roofs and they're performing leaps of faith just like assassins. Okay, Careful. Assassinate the shooter. Oh, I have only like 10 seconds to do so. There we go. Done.
Your plot is ended.
Not quite. Oh, damn you! Fire!
Oh dear. So we killed one of them, but there's a second one, and it's Mr. Lee. I wonder if he knows. Escape the zone and become anonymous. Okay, I will attempt to do so. I see guards on the rooftops. Oh dear.
We have hiding spot.
Okay, I think I did it. Nice. And I got full synchronization, even though I didn't even know what my optional objectives were. So I'm now notorious. The icon indicates that you have reached notoriety level 2. Now the enemies will investigate you on sight. And what can I do about this? Is there anything I can do about it? Oh well, we already have some of them just around the corner. Okay. I hope you're going to move on, because I would like to leave this card of hay. Let's see. My next mission is right over here. So I guess I will try to make my way over there. Undetected, if I can. So let's wait until they have moved on. And now I'm going to sneak through the streets. I mean, I could try to climb the roofs, but there are soldiers up here as well. So this might not be safer. Again, why did you build your city with such wide roads and plazas? This is very inconvenient for assassins, gotta tell you that. And it's making my life a lot harder. They're everywhere. Let's see. Our destination is over here. Okay, I think we almost made it, and I don't see any more guards in my way.
Over here.
All right.
You're Achilles' boy. Connor, was it? I saw what happened at the townhouse. A fine mess, that.
Who are you?
Samuel Adams, at your service. Achilles asked me to get you out of Boston.
Explain.
The whole city's looking for you.
Oh yay, oh yay! A criminal stalks the streets, wanted in connection with the massacre at the townhouse.
It's a good likeness.
Citizens are advised to call the guards if they see him. £10 to whoever brings this madman to
justice. What am I supposed to do?
Well, you can take down these posters for a start.
Of course. That's how you
do it. Return to me once you remove the others.
So, classic Assassin's Creed mechanic, tearing down posters.
Until these posters are gone.
Okay, I have to take down 2 wanted posters. And I guess they are marked on my map over here. Okay. Well, I have that one marked, but it's surrounded by guards, so maybe I should pick a different one. What about the one over here? Well, there's still quite a few guards, but not directly next to it. So if I stay on the roofs for a while, I might be able to get at least a little bit closer. Okay, do we have any guards on the rooftops? Not that I can see. Again, why did you build your streets so wide? Okay, we got one right over here. Oh, we have some guards approaching though. I should probably wait for them to walk away. They do? Okay, they do. Now's my chance. There we go. It's one of them down. Let's quickly head back to the roofs. So my notoriety is a little bit lower now. Again, this one is like surrounded by guards, I believe. Maybe let's get a bit closer to investigate. Where exactly is it? Oh, I see. Yeah, I don't think I want to take down that poster. What about the one over here? Guessing it's that one? 40 meters? Yeah, I think so. Let's have a quick scan around. Soldiers all the way over there, but none in the immediate vicinity. Okay. Okay, let's see. Is that the poster? I think it is. Again, we have like two guards near it. If I wait for them to pass, I should be able to take it down. There we go. So now I have level 1. Enemies will detect you. Okay. I need to go back to Samuel Adams, and he seems to be right over here. So, let's talk to him.
Ah, Connor. There you are. I'd like you to meet Cyrus.
Is he the killer?
Peace. Cyrus is on our side, or rather, for the right price, he will be.
Have you seen this man?
Watch and learn.
Oye, oye! Word has reached us that the man responsible for today's
shooting
may
have
been in disguise. A wig and makeup tin were found near the scene of the crime. Witnesses describe a middle-aged gentleman of pale complexion fleeing towards the wharves, rifle in arm.
Thank you kindly, Cyrus.
Pleasure.
Nice trick.
Come on, man. There's still one last bit of work to do.
Okay, what is it?
Where are we going?
To the printer. Where do you think all those posters came from? They're made by a machine. We need to shut it down.
Good point. Escort Sam to the underground entrance of the Green Dragon Tavern. And I have an optional objective as well. Do not raise your notoriety to level 3. Okay. So, Green Dragon Tavern is over here. And I guess I'm supposed to lead the way and you're going to follow me. I am incognito, but do I want to go close to those soldiers over there? Probably not. Let's try to avoid them if we can. Maybe we can just go through here. There we go. I'm not sure if he's going to follow me through the water, so maybe we're going to take the bridge. And there's quite a few soldiers around. But I think this path should be somewhat safe. Not going through there. Let's take this route. Let's not get into too much trouble here. Well, what would be the best way to get to our destination? Can we go through here? They're everywhere. We have almanac pages, but not going to collect them at the moment. Okay, I think we can go through here. Okay. So, where?
Here we are, then. I'll see you inside.
It's right here. Enter the underground. Okay. Boston's most wanted. And I think I got full synchronization. Nice.
Hold on.
Very dark. Escort Sam through the underground to the Northport exit. Okay. Let's do it. Is there anything around here that I should check out? No? I don't think so. Oh, this is like...
Use your lantern to light the lamps, Connor. They'll help us find our way should we get turned around.
I wonder why they built these tunnels.
Well, probably to get from one point to the other undetected. I mean, we had these tunnels in previous Assassin's Creed games, but they were just fast travel stations. We didn't actually saw them go through them. So where exactly do I have to go to reach my destination? It's in this direction. Let's try to light a few more torches on our way.
Excellent. Let us move on.
So, no enemies down here? Okay. I'm going to take this corridor now?
Much as it pains me to say it, we must follow the rats, as they often move in the direction of an exit.
Oh, I have to follow the rats. Okay, hang on a second. Let me light this over here. Let's see. Do we see any rats? Okay, there we go. That's an interesting method of navigation. Okay, I think this over here is probably the exit. All right. Made it.
Well, well. You were right. I apologize for ever doubting. No wonder Achilles has taken such an interest in you. Arse. I don't suppose lockpicking is part of your repertoire?
I guess it is. You must have gotten that from your father. Move the mouse left and right to locate and hold the tension angle. Yeah, kind of remember how to do it. It's fairly simple, so there we go.
Well done.
Lockpicking success.
The printer isn't far. Let us reconvene there.
All right. Mission complete. Full synchronization. Nice. Meet with Sam Adams. My notoriety is suddenly back to level 1. It used to be lower. Anyway, guess I can't do anything about that at the moment. I mean, I'm not seeing any posters on my map. So, I guess I'm just going for the quest mark again. Oh, look at the turkey over here. It looks magnificent. Look at that. I can pet the turkey. Well, I can feed it. Well, that's something. Anyway, let's not get sidetracked. Let's meet Samuel Adams again. He is somewhere on the other side of this, apparently. Oops, sorry. Didn't see any guards in the vicinity. Alright. The printer shop. Okay.
You ask a great deal of me, Sam.
I know, but I wouldn't be here if it wasn't important, if it wasn't vital.
Fine. Just this once, though. In the future, such things will come at a price. Resetting the type is neither quick nor easy. To say nothing of the cost should I be discovered.
I shall not forget this kindness.
Nor I.
His work will see your last little bit of notoriety erased.
Okay.
Come. I'll show you how to leave now that order's been restored. Oh, now you've had a chance to see how it all works. Untoward actions will upset the citizens and inevitably lead to the guards being called. Depending on the severity of your transgression, they may simply search a bit before giving up and returning to their posts. But should you offend them severely or repeatedly, they'll become much more aggressive in their pursuits. I've shown you 3 ways to turn the tide. Remove wanted posters, bribe town criers, or visit a printer to create your own propaganda.
This feels wrong. Why not just speak to someone and explain my innocence?
You can't be serious.
We counter one lie with another. Words on paper instantly taken as truth, and all of it without question.
They loose this beast, or have you forgotten? I merely helped you tame and turn it round.
There must be another way. Something more honest.
Well, when you find it, do let me know. But until then, we sculpt with the clay we have.
My apologies. I do not mean to sound ungrateful.
Quite all right. I was much the same at your age. You'll grow out of it.
And if I do not? If I refuse?
Then you likely wind up dead.
Probably. I guess Connor still has a lot to
learn. Here we are. Speak with the harbor master and he'll see you home.
Thank you for everything, Sam. I promise one day to repay the favor.
Oh, I'm counting on it.
Like this.
Okay. Guess we made a friend of sorts. We are kind of indebted to him now anyway. Okay, underground, fast travel. So I guess I can now use the tunnels to travel across the map. I mean, we have a fast travel spot over here now. We have one over here. So I guess I have to like find the fast travel spots first and then I can use them as a network. Okay. I think I understand how this works. Yeah. We have a bunch of side missions, but maybe I want to have a look at the codex. You can fast travel easily between cities by zooming out home entirely. Once you have zoomed out, you will see all the possible regions. Ah, okay. Yeah, we have even more stuff going on here, but there isn't really anything to travel to at the moment. I mean, we have the Devonport homestead, but I don't think I will go back there just yet. Instead, let's have another look at the codex and see if there's anything interesting that I would like to read. Animals database. So, what did we get here? It's new entries. Jägers? What is that? Hessians were German soldiers who were hired by the British to fight in the Revolutionary War. While Hessians technically refer to soldiers who were from the state of Hessen-Kassel, it came to be a blanket term for all of the German mercenaries who fought in the Revolution. The imprecision is easy to understand, of course. When a troop of German soldiers lines up and starts firing at you in a war, only the most misguided of geography nerds would stop to ask where they're from. So me, then. Among the Hessian troops who were sent to fight in the American Revolution were at least two units referred to as Jägers. These were light infantry troops known for being accurate marksmen. Accurate marksmen are very much the best sort of marksmen. Good point. The word Jäger also happens to be German for hunter, and early members of the Jäger troops were mainly comprised of experienced foresters. Again, really accurate gunmen who were good at fighting in the woods is exactly the kind of soldier you'd want for a war in the American frontier. Unsurprisingly, this made Jägers the most feared and respected divisions of the Hessians. Interesting. I didn't know that. Samuel Adams. Samuel Adams was a Boston lawyer, a signatory of the Declaration of Independence, and a prominent political figure during the lead up to the American Revolution. I think that's put your little life into perspective, hasn't it? Adams was born in Massachusetts, the son of another Samuel Adams, who was a well-off merchant. Adams, the younger one, went to Harvard, graduating in 1740. He went into business for himself, but was a dismal failure and ended up taking a job in the family brewery. A lot of men turn to breweries when their business fail, but in a rather different way. Okay. And that was fortunate for his historical legacy, since his relationship to beer may be the only reason most Americans have even heard of him. Adams was elected to the Massachusetts legislature in 1765, which was the beginning of his political career. He was a staunch supporter of colonists' rights, mainly the ever popular arguments over whether British Parliament had a right to impose taxes, but wasn't pro-independence, at least not at first. I think it's fair to say he changed his mind later. Adams is often portrayed as an angry radical, but that's a bit of a biased picture. Adams disliked vigilantism for the most part, though he approved when a mob forced Boston's stamp collector to resign, so perhaps he only disliked some vigilantism. In later years, when Adams was in Congress, he refused even to join a political party because he found the idea divisive, a sentiment which he shared with George Washington, incidentally. However, Adams' reputation for being a rabble-rouser is somewhat understandable. He was a representative for the town of Boston after the Boston Massacre and succeeded in having the regulars kicked out of town. He spoke at the Old South Meeting Hall just prior to the Boston Tea Party, and it said he gave the signal for the dumping of the tea, though there's some debate over whether he was involved, which I'm happy about, as a gentleman does not waste tea. Of course, Sean would say that. Adams was infamous enough that he had to leave Boston for Lexington in 1775 to avoid arrest by the British, who considered him a troublemaker. When the siege of Boston began, the Massachusetts governor offered to pardon any rebels who would lay down their arms, except Adams and John Hancock. Overall, Adams certainly was a thorn in the side of the British, though what puzzles me is why some Americans think being an angry revolutionary was a bad thing. It got you where you are today, didn't it? Actually, Hangabout, yes, maybe I see their point after all. Okay. Thanks for that commentary, Sean. The Boston Massacre, I have two codex entries on that for some reason. Massacre on King Street. Doubtless our readers well know that in the evening of Monday last, a squadron of soldiers formed before the Custom House fired into a crowd of citizens, killing four and wounding many. Our readers will expect a circumstantial account of the tragic affair, but we hope they will excuse our being particularly cautious, as we should be, had we not seen that the town was intending an inquiry and full representation thereof. However, some of the few facts appear to be established. Following upon an altercation between some lads of the town and a single posted guard at the Custom House, an increasing number of citizens came to that place, and with that heat shouted down the guard. In like manner, a large group of citizens gathered in King Street. Captain Thomas Preston perceived from the main guardhouse his soldiers in distress and left the main guard with a party of men with charged bayonets. The soldiers came pushing their bayonets, crying, "Make way!" They took place by the Custom House and, continuing to push to drive the people off, pricked some in several places, in which they were clamorous and, it is said, threw some snowballs and perhaps portions of ice. The crowd taunting the soldiers, shouting, "Fire, you dare not fire." On this and more snowballs coming, someone cried out, "Damn you, fire." One soldier then fired, and a townsman with a cudgel struck him over the hand with such force that he dropped his firelock, and rushing forward aimed a blow at the captain's head, which grazed his head and fell pretty heavy upon his arm. However, the soldiers continued to fire successively till 7 or 8, or as some say, 11 guns were discharged. By this fatal maneuver, 3 men were laid dead on the spot and 2 more struggling for life. But what showed a degree of cruelty unknown to British troops, at least since the House of Hanover has directed the operation, was an attempt to fire upon or push with their bayonets the persons who undertook to remove the slain and wounded. The dead are Mr. Samuel Gray, killed on the spot, the ball entering his head and beating off a large portion of his skull. A mulatto named Crispus Attucks, also killed instantly, 2 balls entering his breast, one of them in special, goring to the right lobe of the lungs and a great part of the liver most horribly. Mr. James Caldwell, mate of Captain Morton's vessel, in like manner killed by 2 balls entering his back. Mr. Samuel Maverick, a promising youth of 17 years of age, son of a widow Maverick and an apprentice to Mr. Greenwood, Ivory Turner, a ball went through his belly and was cut out at his back. He died the next morning. Mr. Patrick Carr, about 30 years of age, who worked with Mr. Field, a leather breeches maker in Queen Street, wounded. A ball entered near his hip and went out at his side. Apprehended, he will die. And several others requiring surgery, suffering loss of blood, shattered bones, and lodged musket balls. Governor Hutchinson has exerted himself in an effort to quell the town. He has ordered the arrest of said Captain Preston as well as the soldiers involved until such time as an investigation and general ordering of the facts can be made. I'm going to assume this is like historical record of the event and not written by Sean. So this is probably the version written by Sean over here. But I'm mostly interested in Haytham Kenway's in entry, so finally we get some more info on him. Haytham Kenway is a Templar who came to the American colonies in 1754. From what we've learned, Kenway was sent here by Grand Master Reginald Birch with a dual mission: establish his own Templar group to rival the colonial assassins and search for clues about artifacts related to the first civilization. And when a Grand Master tells you to do something, you do it, even if it's just a chess Grand Master. Kenway didn't find the artifacts he was looking for. He did, however, recruit a small dedicated band of Templars. He also attempted to forge a relationship with the Kanienke Haka on the frontier, and one woman in particular, Kaniezio. The two were briefly lovers, and however brief it was enough because Kaniezio, unbeknownst to Haytham, ended up raising their son Connor. Okay, so he doesn't know about it. I'm guessing it was Kenway who became Grand Master in the colonies and therefore the man responsible for the 1763 attack on the colonial assassins. That attack wiped out most of the membership and almost all of our records from that era. It's never been clear exactly what happened in that attack or how Kenway managed to make it such a complete surprise. In any case, I don't think I like this guy. Sorry to use such strong words. You are excused, Sean. Anyway, I think that's enough Codex reading for the time being. So I am going to end the episode now. And I guess I will do a little bit of exploring in the next episode and, you know, look around town. We have some kind of Harbor Master tutorial over here. Maybe I will check that out. And then I guess we're going back to the homestead to see how our main mission continues. But yeah, let's call it a day for today. And as usual, thank you for watching and see you again next time.